Yes, B, I know it's all my fault. No, I'm not gonna do that right now. Because I have company. It's Levi. No, I am not gonna say that to him. No. Beelzebub would like you to know that he's better than you. And he knows why you cry at night. It's because he's better than you. Okay. No, I already told you, I am not gonna talk dirty to you. B! Oh, you are the scum of the underworld! You lick the boots of the bootlickers! You are an excrement gurgling, maggot snorting, parasite swilling, lord of the flies! You will eat Vegemite for dinner and you will like it! You're welcome. Okay. All right, don't work too hard. I know it's my fault, I do. I know why he's here, I know why you're here. I just can't figure out why I'm here. I just opened a box, and it wasn't even a box, it was a jar, and it was a wedding gift. Who gives you a wedding gift you aren't supposed to open? A sick god, that's who. Even as I was twisting off that lid, I knew something was wrong. It's like that feeling you get when you realize you're the only girl at a frat party. Still, I wonder if I was the cruelest thing I ever did was closing the jar too soon. If I had let Hope escape with all you fuckers, then maybe everything would make sense. But all I did was open a wedding gift, and I gave birth to hell. Now it's my home.
I want to be in charge. I made you. I brought you into existence. I created you. I deserve a throne. I deserve to be worshipped. I deserve to feed off your self-pity. Hope is for the weak, for the frail, for the insignificant. I swallow your hope. I feed. I feed. I feed, and I feel nothing.
Oh, wow. Okay, Levi. Leviathan, that was quite empowering, but, now, what was it that you wanted to talk to me about?
I have a proposition for you.
Hey, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Click right up here. And if you want to see more fun stuff, click right over there.